Hey guys! So I was looking through my stuff the other day and I found this black wig, and I know it does not suit me, it is not my thing, but I thought it would be fun to base a video around it. And even though I'm just changing my hair color, it really does transform the whole look. So I thought it'd be a cute little idea and something a little bit different, which I love to do every now and then. So now I'm just applying my Laura Mercier Silk Cream Foundation all over my face. I love this foundation. It leaves the most flawless finish and it's kind of semi-matte. Next, I'm applying my Urban Decay Naked Skin Concealer around my nose, in the inner corner of my eyes, and underneath my eyes, just to conceal any redness and darkness. We're basically trying to make the skin look as flawless as possible. For powder, I use this Urban Decay Setting Powder. I will leave all of the product names in the description box as always, but with this particular look, I really did want a nice matte finish, kind of like porcelain skin almost. So this powder was perfect for that. Then I use the NYC Sunny Bronzer to contour my cheeks a little bit, not too much. I just kind of wanted, yeah, a little bit of definition. I'm not really sure what to call this look. Like, I'm not really sure what you describe it as, but I had an idea in my head and I just went with it. So hopefully you guys like it. This is a NYX blush. I think it's called Cinnamon, and I haven't used it before, but it is stunning. It looks really, really, really bright in the pan, but it comes out a very, very nice, like, pinky, reddish, orangey shade. Very, very flattering. Now time for brows. I'm using the Urban Decay Brow Box, I think it's called, and I actually went with the darker shade because, of course, I've got black hair. Now this color looks quite red on my eyebrows. I do go over it with a Anastasia Beverly Hills pencil, but I didn't want to have black brows because I found that that would be a little bit too, you know, like, harsh on my face. I want it to be just darker than what I normally do, but not too dark. And you can't even really see them anyway because my little fringe or bangs cover it up. So all good. So as I mentioned, I just used the brow pencil to basically define my brows, just kind of give them a little bit more precision or definition in the arch and towards the tail. I love pencils for that. I love using powders to kind of create the general overall shape, and then using a pencil to kind of define them a little bit more. Then I used some Australis brow gel just to set them in place. I can never leave the house with brows that haven't been set in place. It's just like one of those little weird habits. Then I'm using this Make Up Store pencil, this black eye pencil, and I'm creating the shape of the bottom. I don't know what you call it, but it's basically like a little Cleopatra shape. It's basically just like accentuating the tear duct, the inner corner, bringing it down, and then kind of outlining the lower lash line with the pencil. And then towards the end of the eye, we kind of flick it back downwards. So it's kind of, it's really hard to explain, but I'm sure you'll hopefully understand where I'm coming from or what I'm trying to explain. So yes, as you can see, I'm just kind of flicking it out a little bit, kind of almost mimicking a shadow that your eyelashes would cast upon your face if you had big, thick, Germanic lashes on. That's kind of what I'm going for. Hopefully that explains it. Hopefully. Now I'm just using a Makeup Store Micro Shadow in Pollution, which is pretty much just black, with this Sigma brush, and I'm just blending that out. I'm blending it out with an eyeshadow because it's just a little bit easier, and it means less pulling on my eyes. If I was trying to blend out the pencil, it may be a little bit more difficult. So if you basically just smoke that line out a little bit, and then I'm getting a tapered brush and kind of very delicately blending out the inner kind of tear duct area and then the outer little flick at the end. So you don't have to be too pedantic with this, just kind of creating the illusion of blurred out lines and kind of making it a little bit more smoky and defined. Then I'm going to take a pencil eyeliner from Essence. This is obviously a white one, and I'm going to line the waterline. I'm going to try and make it as opaque as possible. And then I'm going to also kind of fill in that little area in the inner tear duct with white as well. It's kind of like creating the illusion of bigger eyes. Next, I'm going in with an angled brush and that same black eyeshadow and creating a wing. So, of course, trying to make this as symmetrical as possible. This is the hardest part, but using an eyeshadow is much more forgiving than a pencil or a liquid or a gel.
So then I'm just using that tapered brush again to blend out the wing. I want it to be quite soft and not too overpowering or overbearing. I don't want it to stand out too much against the bottom liner because I want them both to be as balanced as possible. Then I'm using that same pencil and I'm lining the upper lash line pretty gently, quite lightly. It doesn't have to be perfect. It's just kind of providing a base for what we're going to do next, which is using that same angled brush and the black eyeshadow and pressing that into the roots of my upper lash line. This just makes it appear a bit more soft than it would if we use the pencil on its own or if we use a liquid or a gel, as I said earlier. So just kind of, maintaining that soft, nice look. Next, I'm using this Kat Von D liquid liner in white and I'm just outlining the outer wings on the lower and upper lash line. And then I'm going to grab a pencil eyeliner, which is that white one that we used earlier, and I'm going to fill in this space. You'll see that happening very soon. I just wanted to use the liquid because it provides a lot more precision. Obviously pencils have a fat tip normally, so it's a little bit harder to get nice and neatly in there, but as you can see, I'm just very softly kind of extending that white. Following that, I'm very, very generously applying this Ardency in Plunker mascara to my upper and lower lashes. Apply as much as you possibly can because we will apply some falsies on the top afterwards, but it always helps to have nice dramatic lashes underneath because it provides a lovely base. So I'm just going to be coating my lashes with that upper and lower and then applying some velour lashes. I think it is their Sephora collection in Flary Tails. So just applying those straight to my lashes. I did use the Duo adhesive in black, I think, and these are velour lash tweezers that help to apply fake lashes. Now that we've done those, I'm going to apply this Maybelline lipstick pencil thing in like a really nice fiery fire engine red. It's kind of like a yellow based red, so it kind of borders on that neon-y orangey shade, which I love. Nothing is perfect for this look, so I'm just going to line my lips like so. Of course you can use a lip pencil if that helps you, but I'm just lazy and I like to go straight in with a pencil. Hope you guys liked this video, even though it's a little bit weird. I hope you like seeing something different. Thank you so much for watching. I love you guys and I'll see you all in my next video. Bye!